This video is an example of the paired T test. As part of the National Health Nutrition Examination Survey, the Department of Health and Human Services obtained self-reported heights and measured heights for males 12 through 16 years. All measurements are in inches. Listed in the table are the sample results. So for example, for each of the 10 subjects, we have two measurements, the height that they say they are, and then the actual measured height. So for example, looking at subject 9, this subject said that he was 63 inches tall, and when he was measured, he was actually 55.6 inches. So this is paired data because there are two measurements taken on the same subject, so we have a dependent case. Is there sufficient evidence to support the claim that there is a difference between self-reported heights and measured heights of males aged 12 through 16? Use a level of significance of 0.05. So we need to write the claim as a mathematical statement in terms of mu sub d, okay, the difference. The paired t-test reduces to a single sample t-test through subtraction. So what we need to do is we need to create a third row or third column of data of differences. So I will be doing that in my TI-84. But going back to the claim is that there is a difference between self-reported heights and measured heights. So if we treat the reported heights as the first sample, we have mu sub 1. And if there is a difference, means that the average for the measured height, being mu sub 2, would not be the same. Okay, so this is the claim. The claim is that the reported average height before is different than the actual measured height. All right, so for the paired t-test, what we do is we rewrite this in terms of one parameter, mu sub d. So moving mu sub 2 over to the left side using subtraction, I'll get 0 on the right side. And I want to relabel this difference here as mu sub d. We don't do this for the independent case, because, for one thing, we don't necessarily have the same sample sizes. And also, the paired t-test, because we have dependent samples, we want to preserve the relationship between the samples. So we indicate that by testing the differences and noting it as mu sub d. Because this does not contain the case of equality, this is the alternative. Okay, so the alternative is mu sub d is not equal to 0. The null in this case will be mu sub d is equal to 0. Again, the alternative is the claim. The test statistic formula is d bar, the sample mean for the differences, minus the hypothesized difference over the standard deviation of the differences over the square root of n, where n is the number of pairs of data. So looking at the value on the right side of the hypotheses, the claim difference for this particular problem will be 0, so we'll be subtracting 0 here. We know what n is. N is the number of pairs of data. We have 10 subjects, so n is equal to 10. So for the other pieces, we're going to need d bar and s sub d. So to do that, I could manually subtract the first row's values and the second row's values, in other words, the actual subtracted from the reported Okay, I could do that manually and create a third row here of the differences, but I'm going to have the calculator do that for me. I've already inputted the differences, I'm sorry, the values in list 1 and list 2. So here are all of the reported values, here are all of the measured values. So I can arrow over to list 3, up arrow so that it's highlighted, press enter, and it moves the cursor down to the bottom of the screen. And then I just tell the calculator I want to take list 1 and subtract list 2. So I'll have my column of differences here. D bar will be the sample mean for this third column. To get that, and this should be review, you want to go to your stat menu, go to calc, select one variable statistics, and those differences are in list 3. So my average difference, D bar, is negative 1.23. And that standard deviation for that third list is right here. It's 5.624. So after you have all of the pieces, it's pretty straightforward to input into the test statistic formula. I'll have negative 1.23 minus 0 over 5.624 over the square root of 10. Okay, that standardized test statistic will be negative. And inputting that into my calculator, I get negative 0.691. Now I want to take this test statistic and compare it to a critical value. Actually, there will be two critical values because this is a two-tailed test. The critical values are on the t-distribution, which is bell-shaped with a mean of 0. Because I have a two-tailed test, my level of significance is divided in half, and I have an equal amount of area in each tail of rejection. So if alpha is 0.05, one tail will have 0.025 amount of area. And these two critical values will be symmetric. This is the same way you found a critical value for a single sample t-test. The degrees of freedom for the paired t-test is n minus 1, which is the number of pairs of data, minus 1. So the degrees of freedom for this example will be 9. Going to my t-table with the super small font, I have 0.025 in that right tail and 9 degrees of freedom. So the upper critical value is positive 2.62. I'm sorry, 2.262. That makes the lower one negative 2.62 by symmetry. So comparing where the standardized test statistic is placed with respect to these critical values, the standardized test statistic is in the fail to reject region. So the decision is to fail to reject the null. And the conclusion will be that there is not enough evidence to support the claim that there is a difference between self-reported heights and measured heights. Now, to get the same information, in other words, to get the standardized test statistic directly from the calculator and the p-value, we can do a single sample t-test on that third list. There is no direct paired t-test in the calculator. However, we can do this workaround if we've created that third column of differences. I already have that in my calculator, that list of L1 minus L2. So going to my stat menu, over to tests, I can select option 2, the single sample t-test. And in this problem, I have the data in a column. I need to put in the claimed difference here from the null, and that is 0. My list of differences is in list 3, and I'm changing this to be a two-tailed test. So looking at the output, where'd my output go? Because I did some rounding with the sample standard deviation, my test statistic is slightly different, okay, but not by much, not enough to change the decision. And here's the corresponding p-value. The p-value is 0.507. Comparing it to my level of significance of 0.05, the p-value is greater than or equal to 0.05, so that is consistent with the decision to fail to reject the null hypothesis from the critical value method.